accused of causing a deadly crash last month on I-55. Prosecutors say the trucker has no vision in his right eye, and that prevents him from driving safely. Good evening. Five people were killed in that crash.
The truck driver, Francisco Espinal Quiros, is now charged with reckless homicide. New at 5 o'clock, Eyewitness News reporter Paul Mikey has the latest details about the case. Paul?
Stacey and Ron, with five lives lost in last month's horrific crash on I-55, it's not a surprise that more serious criminal charges have come against the truck driver. He's already being held on a $1 million bond. What may come as something of a surprise is that Francisco Espinal Quiros was driving a big tractor-trailer rig with a legal waiver because he is blind in one eye. He was speeding in a construction zone, failed to slow, didn't keep a proper lookout for other vehicles, and according to the indictment, Francisco Espinal Quiros has a physical condition that limits his ability to drive safely. A 2006 posting on the Federal Motor Carrier Safety Administration website says Espinal Quiros has a complete loss of vision in his right eye due to a traumatic injury sustained 30 years ago. In other words, he is an over-the-road trucker with one good eye. Truckers with vision impairment can legally drive tractor trailers provided they demonstrate a safe driving record and get clearance from an eye doctor. They are then eligible for a waiver from the federal government. After a 2005 examination, Espinal Quiros' optometrist, who is unnamed, wrote, "Mr. Espinal has excellent vision in his left eye. I feel he has sufficient vision to perform the driving tasks required to operate a commercial vehicle. A driver with one good eye has to demonstrate adequate peripheral vision."
And the standard is that you need to have 140-degree peripheral vision, which is like about here.
Dr. Cheryl Kraft Cooper does not have access to the vision records of Espinal Quiros, but suggests that peripheral vision is the key.
Truck drivers, also depending upon the size of the truck, need to have a lot of other things, better fine motor skills, and if you're missing certain visual things, your depth perception can be off also, so that could be a problem.
The indictments do not specifically say that Espinal Quiros' blindness in one eye caused the accident. There may have been multiple factors, but sources say investigators were stunned to find after the accident that the trucker is blind in one eye. In order to legally drive, given his limited eyesight, Espinal Quiros had to keep his federal waiver current, meaning a vision re-exam every 2 years. Sources say that his waiver had expired. In May of this year, the Federal Motor Carrier Safety Administration started a new system that grants only doctors it certifies with the power to recommend waivers. It's not clear if Espinal Quiros made any attempt to renew his waiver. He remains, as I said, held on $1 million bond. He has an arraignment for September 9.
All right. Thank you very much for that, Paul.